Excuse me, officer. I just got robbed by Sisley. Hello, hello. Bonjour, everyone. Welcome or welcome back to my channel. My name is Cyril. I used to be a stem cell researcher for quite some time, and this is why I can tell you about the science behind skincare ingredients. And for today's video, I am going to basically talk about one face cream that is super duper extra, extra, mega, ultra cher. Very, very expensive, which is one from a French brand, a very, I would say, famous brand, at least in terms of luxe product, which is from Sisley. This is the Sisley Intégrale Anti-Age, which means basically like the global or the total anti-aging cream. I'm like, girl, no! My God, this stuff retail for $530. For a damn moisturizer, as you are going to see. So the whole idea of this type of video are basically why I would never buy those products. Even if those products were sent to me in PR, maybe I will open them and try them on my hands. Am I going to put this on my face? No, basically no. And also this whole idea of those videos is just to show you that when you just read the list of ingredients, this is how you can tell that yes, this product is worth a try, even though it might be a little bit expensive, and this one basically not, and there are much better alternative. I mean, at the end of the day, especially for this specific product, it is targeted for those of you who have who wants to treat anti-aging. And what are the best active for anti-aging? Well, the first one is of course sunscreen, and I'm going to have another review of an amazing sunscreen for you this week. You know the drill with me. Only choose SPF 50 plus, a UVA protection of at least 4 PA rating if it is an Asian one. If it is not in Europe and in Australia, it will have at least a UVA protection of 20. I mean, this is for me the minimum. The whole idea is the less UV goes into your skin, the less aging, and the more happy will skin you be, basically. So this is what you need to look for. The other ingredients are what? Retinoids, of course, in the form of retinol or tretinoin. I do not advise you to go with retinaldehyde. Why? Because we don't have the proof that when you apply retinaldehyde on top of the skin, it is going to boost the collagen, the elastin, the hyaluronic acid, the proteoglycans, and all that jazz that we have in the dermis, which is exactly what you want, because of course you want to reverse some of the anti-aging sign, but you also want to keep your skin in young mode for the longest. And you will see that none of those ingredients are in this moisturizer, because this is basically a moisturizer and probably also a good one. And there are also some problematic ingredients. I don't say toxic ingredient, because well, all the toxic ingredients are illegal, but there are some ingredients that are known that can trigger allergic reaction, and this is a way safer for you to just avoid them. So if you just look at the formula, because this is a moisturizer, the rationale is always the same. You need, first of all, good humectants that are going to attract the water from the cream and to increase the water content in your skin. Of course, an hydrating toner, hydrating serum, hydrating lotion, whatever the name, I would be more suitable to increase the water content, but this is still very important to have them on your moisturizer. And then you are going to need emollients, and from time to time, occlusive. Those two types of family of ingredients are the ones that are going to help your skin to retain the water. To give you a very, very simple image, if you take a glass of water, you pour the water on top, you add a layer of oil, the layer of oil is going to prevent the evaporation of water. This is basically the rationale of a moisturizer. So here, if you look at the formula, we have first of all water, which is beautiful. Then we have shea butter. Shea butter is an excellent source of good emollients, and it has a lipid profile that is very compatible with the skin. Then we have cocoa caprylate caprate, which is basically an alternative to volatile silicone such as cyclopentoxyloxan, which are absolutely fine. So this one is just going to give like this very luxe feel to the cream, like you know, those cream that glides beautifully. They are due to the type of ingredients such as cocoa caprylate. This one is derived from coconut, then, which doesn't make it better than a silicone, by the way. Then we have a squalane. I mean, you know that I love my squalane. I have a video actually between the difference between squalane and squalene. This is a little bit different, but basically squalane is an excellent, excellent emollient. And also it is very, very similar to squalene that we already have in our sebum, so it is going to really help to moisturize the skin and to retain the water. Then we have a beautiful oil, which is sunflower seed oil. This is also in one of my favorite moisturizer from COS AX, which is the ultimate nourishing overnight mask. I mean, I love this one. I have currently in my apartment, not right here in my studio, but this is a beautiful one. Now, if we look at what they consider to be the actives, they are mostly plant derived. This is always the moment when you need to be a little more careful. Of course, plant derived ingredients are not necessarily bad and dreadful for the skin, of course not, but you are always taking a little risk. This is of course a very low risk. If you don't have any major sensitive, if you don't have a very sensitive skin and not notorious, of course, allergen towards those type of ingredients, it could be fine, but always be very careful when you're introducing those botanical extract. What I would always suggest you is that the moment that you want to try one product, and I'm thinking in a future review, I will talk about one, for example, that does have a lot of botanical ingredients that are not fragrance. You just introduce one product for at least a solid week in your routine and you see how your skin reacts. If your skin is a happy baby, okay, keep on using it. If you see that you have a little bit of sensitization or something like that, it means that some of those botanical ingredients are just not for you. Here, the botanical ingredients have basically have almost no scientific data. Are they going to make a change in your anti-aging routine? Absolutely not. No, I mean, I'm sorry. And I guess you already know, even with 1% retinol, which is basically one of the most powerful stuff that you can get in over-the-counter skincare, are you going to look like 10 or 20 years younger thanks to it? No. So you can imagine with only those botanical extracts that have absolutely no scientific data or barely any, are they going to transform your skin? No, of course not. So we have hydrolyzed soy proteins, which are basically going to be mostly good humectant. We do have panthenol, which is actually quite soothing for the skin, so this is good. We have also vitamin E. We have, like I said, a bunch of botanical extracts. I'm not going to comment on them because there are basically no scientific data. We have some very problematic ingredients right here. We have two extracts from essential oils, lavender oil. So it happened that I am sensitive to it. Every time I try a product with lavender essential oil, I try to have an irritation, especially on the side of my nose. I don't like it a lot. And we also have another essential oil from Thymus Mastichina flower. Oh boy, but this is an essential oil. Basically, also if you go at the end, we also have derivative of essential oils, linalool, limonel, and also geraniol. Those one has to be listed outside of the fragrance name because they are really known skin sensitizer in quite many person. Also, if you go at the end of the formula, this is where you find the preservative system in the form of ethyl ethyl glycerin and also phenoxyethanol. And we also have two pH adjusters. So basically, when the formulator is creating the formula, when they are done with all the actives and etc., they are going to measure the pH in order to make it between 6 and 5. Unfortunately, most moisturizer will be around 6 to almost 7. It should be better if they were more around 5 and 5.5, because this is the pH of the top surface of the skin. And they use citric acid, which is very, very common. So this one is to lower the pH, and also sodium hydroxide in order to increase the pH to be in those value. And basically that's it. So basically you are paying more than $500 for a cream that is devoid of any gold standard active that are really going to impact your skin. There is also no, I would say, really bougie technology, like for example encapsulation, nano emulsions, something like that. At least a damn peptide. There is not even a damn peptide. Oh, I'm also thinking about this brand. I have done a very old review about this one. This is Active Layer. Those are the 5 seconds nano collagen boost. This doesn't have a lot of scientific data on it, but the way that it is made, it's so, so clever and so, so innovative. So at least for the price, you are paying for something. This one has been sent to me, by the way, in PR, and I did really enjoy it. And I also find that the whole process of making this one is very interesting. But in this one, I mean, you are basically paying for probably a very good moisturizer with potential irritants, and voila. So am I going to recommend on this channel for you to spend that much money for a damn simple moisturizer? Of course not, of course not. So comment down below, tell me if you want me to do more videos like this where I basically talk about a formula. If you did like this video, give it a huge thumbs up. Thank you again so much for being here. Also, don't forget to subscribe to my channel and to ring the bell to not miss any of my new videos. You can also check my Instagram account. I know I always say the same thing, but I do a lot of lives, so if you want to interact with me, this is definitely the place to go. Thank you so much, and I will see you next time. Au revoir!